We're in Sussex, Wisconsin, 10 miles north of Waukesha, on Canadian National's former Wisconsin Central mainline, with a southbound manifest approaching, led by a quartet of Canadian National GEs. CN purchased the WC in October 2001, and has since increased traffic over the line, as well as double-tracking sections around Ackerville and over Byron Hill. We're on a bike trail bridge over the main line. The approaching southbound will meet a northbound in Waukesha. A southbound ballast train stops at the end of double track in Ackerville, where it will sit for nearly 2 hours for a northbound. Nearby, a Wisconsin and Southern manifest leaves the yard at Ackerville, heading south towards Rugby Junction. Thank you. Wisconsin and Southern interchanges traffic with the CN at Ackerville. A pair of GP38-2s, one in WSOR paint, and the other in former Union Pacific paint, now lettered for WAMX, switched the yard. Wisconsin Southern was purchased by the leasing outfit Watco in 2012. Another Wisconsin Southern train, with a trio of GP38-2s, arrives at Ackerville. The power will detach from the train and pick up another one here, while the other power set yards this train. As the second train pulls into the yard, a Canadian National southbound approaches. Once the second train clears the main, the trio of Jeeps will start their journey south. On a dreary afternoon, as a southbound unit oil train passes some farming equipment. Thank you. There's a good deal of public land across this part of Wisconsin. A northbound manifest, led by a trio of newer GEs, is seen from the edge of a farm field outside Theresa. A southbound manifest will arrive a short time later, along with heavy rain. Norfolk Southern Power leads a northbound manifest toward the Route 28 overpass north of Theresa as the rain continues. Of EMDs lead hot stack train Q199 north under the Route 28 overpass, seen from a field north of the bridge. a pair of GP40-2Ws switched the quad graphics plant south of Byron. Byron Hill is one of the most recognizable locations on this line. A rail grinder heads north to Fond du Lac just after sunset. CN double-tracked Byron Hill shortly after their purchase of the WC. A northbound manifest, led by a ubiquitous pair of Jivos, tops the grade on its way to Fond du Lac. A CN GP40-2W and a Grand Trunk Western GP9R lead a local back to Fond du Lac in the late evening. CN8100, one of the four demonstrator SD70 Aces CN purchased, leads a manifest up the grade of Byron Hill. southbound struggles up the grade of Byron Hill with a pair of Gevos leading. Shoving on the rear are Illinois Central and Grand Trunk Western SD40-3s. He will meet a northbound at Byron. Just south of Fond du Lac, as a pair of Illinois Central SD40-3s lead a local back to town. Thanks for joining me for this look at Canadian National's former Wisconsin Central, Waukesha sub.